That was at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, more than
I don't know.
3 hours after the attack started.
But there were tweets that were put out before that.
I want to know who you called.
By the way,
on that day,
Nancy Pelosi. I don't have. Why would I tell you that?
Donald Trump was asked by Kristen Welker on Meet the Press why he refused to help members of Congress by deploying National Guard troops as the January 6 riots were underway. Now, his answer was full of lies, but before I get to debunking those lies, why don't we hear what he had to say in greater context?
You, as commander in chief, you have authorities that Nancy Pelosi doesn't have as commander in chief.
No, she has authority over the
Capitol.
Why
didn't you send help in that moment, though?
Frankly, just so you understand, I assumed that she took care of it. She turned down.
So when you realized that the National Guard wasn't coming?
Well, you don't realize anything until quite a while. National Guard not coming. I asked it to be there 3 days in advance, and she turned it down.
She says that request was never officially made.
Oh,
just so
it.
You know.
Let me just tell you.
Let me ask you about
mayor
pardons,
of
let
Mr.
Me President.
Tell you, the mayor of D.C. gave us a letter saying that she turns it down. Okay, we have it. Nancy Pelosi also was asked, and she turned it down. The police commissioner
I'm talking
of
about
Capitol
the day
Police,
of
wait a minute.
Yep.
Capitol Police said that he wanted it, and Nancy Pelosi wouldn't accept it. She's responsible for January 6th.
So let's talk a little bit about how this process actually works. Because even if Nancy Pelosi wanted that kind of power, she doesn't have that kind of power. The Speaker of the House does not have that kind of power. So what do I mean by that? So the way that the National Guard troops would be deployed in a situation like this is if the so-called Capitol Police Board gets together and they unanimously decide this is what we're gonna do. Now, what consists of the Capitol Police Board? You have the House Sergeant at Arms. That's not Nancy Pelosi. That was a guy at the time by the name of Paul Irving. He actually resigned the day after January 6th. He did report to Pelosi, but Pelosi's not the one who's part of this board that makes the decision. Paul Irving was part of that board. Then you have the Senate Sergeant at Arms, the individual who reports to the Senate Majority Leader. At the time, it was Mitch McConnell. That guy's name at the time, Michael Stanger. He was the Senate Sergeant at Arms. And then you have the architect of the Capitol, Brett Blanton, who had all sorts of issues. We'll get to him in just a moment. And then there's the chief of police for the Capitol Police, right? And at the time, that's Stephen Sund, okay? So the board decided against calling the guard ahead of January 6th. They had a conversation about it, they decided against it, but then they requested troops after the rioting was already underway. That is how the process works. So even if, by the way, there's no evidence of this happening, but even if someone approached Nancy Pelosi specifically and said, yo, we're offering you up 10,000 National Guard troops, what do you say? She doesn't have the ability to either approve or deny that request unilaterally. And I do find it fascinating that Trump is so hyper-focused on Nancy Pelosi, who's the person that the House Sergeant at Arms reports to. But what about the Senate Sergeant at Arms, which reported to, or who reported to Mitch McConnell at the time? Is he irrelevant in all of this?
No, nothing matters, guys. So look, the National Guard is in the executive branch. Nancy Pelosi doesn't have some authority over the National Guard. She has no authority over the National Guard. It's like saying, why didn't the mayor of San Antonio call in the National Guard in DC? Because he's not the president of the United States, and that's what the president can do, and only the president, in conjunction with this board getting their recommendation and following through in a normal process that the executive branch does. So he says at one point in that interview, I assumed she took care of it. You assume Nancy Pelosi, who is not in the executive branch, took care of the National Guard, so that's why you didn't do your job? I don't understand how anybody believes this guy. I just don't, guys, come on. All right, he says, she's responsible for January 6th. Yeah, they were trying to kill her that day. So she thought, oh yeah, why don't I just invite a bunch of my political opponents, in fact, the most deranged of them, the ones willing to break into the Capitol and murder me and Trump's own vice president. Yeah, I'd love to do that. But yet, go on social media, and what you will see from MAGA, wall to wall, is it was Nancy Pelosi.
Yeah, it is amazing, and it shows Look, I don't expect anyone to know how this process actually works, right? And what you have here is Donald Trump essentially taking advantage of or exploiting, you know, I think the general ignorance that most Americans have about how this process works. So it's very easy to lie to people and especially get Trump supporters to believe that the person responsible for not calling for help from the National Guard troops was Nancy Pelosi. Of course, that's not the case. By the way, I want to give you some more details about what transpired that day. So remember, all of this had been investigated as part of the House Select Committee investigating January 6th. So Stephen Sund, the Capitol Police Chief during the riots, testified to the Senate panel that by 1:09 p.m. on the afternoon of the riot, he notified both Irving and Stanger of the department's need for a state of emergency declaration and National Guard troops, which was not approved by the Capitol Police Board until after 2 p.m. It took over an hour for them to finally approve it after the riots had already been underway. Okay, Irving said he did not recall getting a request for the National Guard until shortly after 2 p.m. Now, after the investigation, some of the laws have changed, which I think makes a lot of sense. So according to a roll call in late 2021, President Joe Biden signed a bill into law that lets the Capitol Police Chief ask for National Guard help without the approval of the Capitol Police Board. And I said I would get to the architect of the Capitol, right? At the time, the person serving in that role was Brett Blanton. So Brett Blanton said he avoided coming to the Hill on January 6th of 2021. He explained that he thought it wouldn't be prudent to drive to work that day, a revelation that infuriated lawmakers on the House Administration Committee panel, which investigated this. Instead, he said his official vehicle served as the agency's mobile command post during the January 6th attack, where he listened to police radio and directed personnel from afar.
Yeah, it was mobile because you were getting the hell out of Dodge when you were supposed to get in there and help. That is hilarious framing. So look, we tell you 1,000 times over, you know, yes, Trump is a pathological liar, but the press makes it seem like he's the only one in power that lies. No, most of the people in power lie all the time, just not as spectacularly as Trump. I think one of our members on YouTube nailed this as to why he didn't respond. And people don't say this often enough, and I think it's exactly right. Night Eater wrote in, Trump sat in his corner hoping the coup succeeded. Once it failed, he finally spoke. Exactly right, okay? He sat there for 3 hours watching TV, hoping, go get him guys, go get him. Meanwhile, we know from witness testimony, Mark Meadows, his chief of staff, comes in and says, Mr. President, they're talking about murdering the vice president, your vice president, Mike Pence. And he says, Mike deserved it. And he goes back to watching to see if they're gonna succeed. And once he realizes, oh yeah, how could they possibly take the building and then keep it? The only people who could believe that are the idiots that were on the ground and Donald Trump. No, they were supposed to delay the proceedings and then the Republicans were supposed to panic and the Democrats were supposed to panic and bring it back to the states. But they didn't panic. And once they didn't panic, finally it dawned on Trump, oh right, this can't possibly work. Then he comes out and makes a statement, oh okay, I guess you guys can go home now that the coup failed.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.